Hi, I'm Pattu from Free FinCal. Today, let's talk about an idea in retirement planning called the safe withdrawal rate. And it is known by a more popular rule called the 4% rule. And in this video, I want to discuss why we need to stop using this idea of safe withdrawal rate and even the 4% rule. Now, what is the withdrawal rate and why is there a safe withdrawal rate? So let's get back to Excel after a long time. So I have an article called Four Simple Calculators for Retirement or something like that, and this is from there. And I have one of the four calculators is how long will a corpus last. So suppose I have a corpus of 1 crore and I want to think about retirement today immediately, and I'm going to assume that the inflation rate is 7% and the interest, the post-tax interest on the overall corpus after retirement is always going to be 7%. So it's a very simplistic calculation. If that is the case, and if the amount I need in the first year, that is the first year's annual expenses, is about 4 lakhs, is only 4 lakhs, I should say, then the corpus would last for 25 years. So that is, I take this 1 crore and I invest it in such a way that it gives me a return of 7% every year. At the start of every year, I withdraw an amount initially at 4 lakhs, and after that, every year that withdrawal will increase at the rate of 7%. So at the start of the year, I'll withdraw the money required for the entire year, and the rest of the corpus will grow at 7% a year. So if these assumptions are made, then the corpus will, initially it will start growing and then it will start falling because I'm going to withdraw more and more. I'll show you a graph in a minute. Then it'll start falling, and then at the end of 25 years, it'll go to zero. So for 25 years, I can be financially independent after retirement, in the sense that I can draw a income that increases every year at the rate of 7% from my corpus. So withdrawal rate is defined as the amount needed in the first year of retirement, that is 4 lakhs, divided by this corpus I have at that time. So that's 4 lakhs by 1 crore is obviously 4%. So that's called the withdrawal rate. Now, what is a safe withdrawal rate? Now obviously what happens is that if suppose I change this to 5 lakhs, then the corpus will only last for 20 years and the withdrawal rate becomes 5%. That is, it becomes higher. So the more I withdraw, that is, the more my expenses or the lesser the corpus, my withdrawal rate will be higher. Even if it is high in the first year itself, then what will happen in subsequent years? So expenses are increasing at the rate of 7%. The corpus is earning at the rate of 7%, and you can see initially the withdrawal is small, so the corpus increases, but then the withdrawal keeps increasing more and more due to inflation, and then it falls down and drops to zero at the end of 25 years. This is for 4 lakh initial expenses. So the withdrawal rate is initially 4%, and then because of inflation and you are going to keep drawing more and more, so the withdrawal rate will gradually keep increasing, and then it will dramatically increase to 100% at the end of 25 years. So it must first be understood that withdrawal rate refers to only the annual expenses divided by the corpus in the first year alone. The rest of all these red dots are irrelevant. They are only to illustrate that they are irrelevant. Withdrawal rate is irrelevant. What matters is what is the withdrawal rate in the first year. Now, there are many people in the so-called FIRE communities, financially independent early retirement communities on Reddit, wherever, here and there. They will say, I will manage my portfolio such that in any year after retirement, my withdrawal rate will be 4% or less. This is nonsense. I have mentioned this in the article itself. So this idea of safe withdrawal rate was proposed by William Bengen, and he has a Reddit Ask Me Anything himself, and he makes it very clear in this. If you go to the article, I will link the article in the description today. He makes it very clear that the 4% rule is actually 4.5% rule, because he had back tested this with US equity data, And he says after the first year, you throw away the 4.5% rule and you increase the withdrawals as per inflation. And he makes it very clear in the very first comment of the Reddit AMA, it's linked here. So the withdrawal rate itself has no meaning other than the first year. So what is the meaning of safe? So the idea is what value of withdrawal rate can handle the market ups and downs so that the corpus doesn't deplete. So according to his research made in the early 90s, 94, I think, he suggested that any withdrawal rate less than or equal to 4.5% is reasonably safe. Anything above that is very risky for the retiree, and the retiree will have to adjust their expenses or increase their corpus via some expenses and so on. So that's where the notion of safe comes in. Safe means what is the initial withdrawal rate that will ensure future withdrawals will not deplete the corpus before our lifetime. So if the initial withdrawal rate itself is 5%, then all future withdrawal rates will anyway be higher than that. So that's the concept of safety. So our goal should be that we have to keep the initial withdrawal rate as low as possible. Now here comes the problem. Now if we are a young person, our retirement is 15 years away, 10 years away, 20 years away, whatever, we have time, we have at least a decade or more to plan things, then the notion of the initial withdrawal rate is not relevant to us at all. We have all the time in the world to plan a proper bucket strategy after retirement. For example, in my robo advisory template, I ensure that the person has guaranteed inflation protected income for the first 15 years. That's the income bucket. Then there are three buckets: low risk bucket, medium risk bucket, high risk bucket. It has to be actively managed and so on. So you can plan this kind of detailed bucket strategy when you have time for retirement. So the idea of safe withdrawal rate is not necessary at all now. You have to worry about it only at the time of retirement, but you are going to plan now, which means that you're going to start investing right and investing enough from now on. That's the assumption we're going to make. The idea of safe withdrawal rate makes gains importance only when a retiree suddenly wakes up and says, okay, I'm going to retire today. I'm going to go to a financial advisor and I'm going to tell them my annual expenses are 5 lakhs. I'm going to invest in 7%. My inflation is 7%. Corpus is 1 crore. Can the money last for 25 years? The advisor will say, no, it will not, because your initial withdrawal rate is 5%. It is above what is necessary for the corpus to last for 25 years. So for the corpus to last 25 years, we saw that the withdrawal rate should be 4% only. Now it is 5%. So now for the advisor or for the investor, the DIY investor, the challenge is the initial withdrawal rate is greater than what it should be on paper. What should I do? Should I take the corpus and just buy an annuity and get a pension? Or should I take some risk for some part of the corpus? This is a open problem in personal finance. It's very hard to solve, and particularly in India, investment advisors have very little experience handling retirees. Giving them advice on capital markets, because most retirees don't have enough corpus to go to an advisor. They will simply buy PM Vaya Vandana Yojana, senior citizen scheme, this and that, and then finish off most of the corpus. Their corpus is done. So there's no question of capital market risk for most of them. Only now the new age retirees, people from IT industries or other industries, corporate guys who are well paid, who have enough corpus to speak of, only now they'll be going to advisors, and the advisors themselves will need some experience, because nobody can say what is safe withdrawal. It's an arbitrary concept in the sense that if for Indian markets, what is safe? We don't know. Even in the US markets, there is enough discussion, and Avinash Luthria has a very nice article at Free FinCal, which says that the 4% rule is wrong. So a lot of people are saying 4% is wrong, you have to have a lower withdrawal rate and so on. That's all fine. But if the withdrawal rate is higher, if the retiree's expense is higher than required, than what it should be, or the corpus is lower than what it should be, what should the advisor do? At what withdrawal rate should the advisor say, take risk, or don't take risk. This is an open problem anywhere. At least in the US, there's some analysis, some data, some of the advisors, at least a few of them will have some experience. But in India, that experience is sorely lacking. Very few advisors discuss about it, at least in by way of articles and so on. So this is the big problem. So at least for young earners, I would suggest that don't worry about withdrawal rates now. Don't talk about I will live within 4% withdrawal rate every year in retirement and so on. Those notions are completely, utterly nonsensical. The idea of safe withdrawal rate is relevant only for the retiree who is just about to start their retired life, and of course that comes with their own problems. I once did a calculation and I suggested that if the retiree does not have 80% of the corpus required for inflation protected income, they should not take risk. At least you can, as a thumb rule, I had said 80%, 85%. Maybe you can relax it to 75%. So they must have at least 75% of the corpus required for inflation protected income. If they don't have that, then it's not worth taking on capital market risk. This is my thumb rule. But the problem in our country is, which I failed to mention earlier, is most of our advisors have a conflict of interest. They will be saying, you start an SWP in a balanced advantage fund, get monthly dividend income, and all sort of nonsensical advice will follow. So it's even more dangerous. So there's a lot of research that needs to be done with real retiree data in India, but that's missing. Not only is our capital market history short, real client data is also very less. So there's a lot more to be done. But at least this good news is the young guys don't have to worry about it. They can have a proper bucket strategy plan. Bye-bye.